Good morning. It's Friday, the 23rd of February, 2024. And I want to welcome you to my channel. It's a commentary channel, and anything and everything gets discussed. Now, lately, I've been doing a series about conversations. But before I upload content or discuss content on conversations, I want you guys to know that I am a conspiracy theorist. I believe in conspiracies, and you only have to read a book I published, and please go to Amazon to get any of my books that I've published, Amazon, and get the latest one. And the latest one looks like it's got an orangey kind of fire on the front, and it's called Seeing the Spirituality Behind the Negativity, A Menu for the Game of Life. Originally, it was published in 2015, but I republished it about 2020 or 2022, and this new or republishing contains extra material that I did in 2015. So if you get the blue one, you're paying way too much, because the one from Amazon is cheaper. And the book is about automatic writing, channeled material, and a lot of it contains conspiracies. Anyway, back to today's material and continuing along the lines of conversations. This isn't new. This has been around for a long time, about the Apollo landings on the moon. But I heard a conversation recently that has refreshed it all for me again, because we tend to forget, don't we? Something else comes along and it takes away things. And this is the conversation, the content, the conspiracy about the Apollo moon landings, that they never happened. Now, why? And why do I say that? Well, the first part of the conspiracy is when Buzz Aldrin and the other two guys, when they first walked on the moon, and I can remember sitting there in 1967 as a kid watching this on telly and thinking, what a marvel. Now remember, at this time, America was in a space war with Russia. Now, why do I believe it's faked? Here goes. We already know that if you look at the flag, it's waving, and there is no wind on the moon. Okay, when Buzz Aldrin sticks the flag into the moon's surface, he gives it a bit of a shake. So yes, the flag can wave, but it still keeps waving. Secondly, is shadows. If you look at the shadows of an astronaut, and shadows are caused by the sun casting a shadow. If you look at the astronauts, you can see a shadow, but if you carefully look at the shadow of a rock, it's at a 90 degree angle difference. There should not be a difference. If you walked outside, stood next to me, and we stood under a tree, all our shadows would be at the same direction, the same angle. Why else do I believe that it is a lie? Is because there is, I used to know the name of this, a very famous, it's got a name, it's a radiation belt that we have to get through, that I don't think at the time we had the capabilities of getting through this radiation belt. And the other reason is apparently when the three astronauts came back and were interviewed, they were absolutely miserable. Now, wouldn't you be going, yahoo, I did the thing, you know, I was the first person in the whole world to walk on the moon. But they're miserable. You look at them, they look like someone's walked, you know, some over their graves. They're not happy. They're not joyous. Now, I can hear you debunkers saying that there were 144,000 NASA employees. How could they keep this lie silent? Easy. They were deceived too. The rocket did go into outer space, but only into Earth's far-reaching outer orbit. That's all. The other reason why is this. Why did, after all the Apollo missions ended, why were all the ships destroyed and all the blueprints to the Apollo missions destroyed? Look it up. These are facts. I'm not just being a conspiracist here. These are facts. And I have to thank listening to Down a Rabbit Hole for this. And this conversation also goes on that the girl talking about this said that we have actually gone backwards in technology. It's over. I'm 63. And I watched this at primary school. I watched them landing on the moon. I was 6 or 7. So we're going on over 50 years ago, or 50 years ago, or 60 years ago, nearly. And in 60 years, we've gone backwards. Since those Apollo missions of so-called landing on the moon, it's never been achieved again. We have Elon Musk trying to go to the moon, Mars, sorry. He's got money galore. You think that NASA would be helping him? Why did NASA destroy blueprints? So with all our technological advances, especially in robotics, especially in the World Wide Web, the internet, with our mobile phones, we haven't conquered space. We did it 50 years ago, but now we can't do it. And if we did achieve it 50 years ago, don't you think we would have kept those blueprints so that we could now go back to the moon or go back to Mars? Just saying. So, thank you to the girl. This is Conversations. I was the listener again. These aren't my ideas. This is me listening and bringing up an old topic. So do I believe we went to the moon? No. I do believe we've gone out of space. But I believe that somewhere, and I think Steven Spielberg, and this didn't come from the rabbit hole, I believe Steven Spielberg was probably involved, if not, in this lie, and it was made perhaps even in Area 51. Who knows where they made this fake moon landing? Okay, I can hear you debunkers again saying, well, how come Buzz Aldrin says there were alien spacecraft on the moon? Do you know what? We are waiting for disclosure. And we're being fed little bits of truth within lies. So disinformation. And it's up to us to open our eyes and see what is true and what is lies. Of course, they're going to say that there were alien craft on the moon because we're already onto them. We already know of UFOs. So they're just giving us a little piece. So by telling us that they saw alien spacecraft on the moon, we would buy into their lie that they were on the moon. But in telling us that there's alien spacecraft, they're admitting to the fact that there are UAPs or whatever unidentified objects, I'm going to call them, okay? So on one hand, they're perpetuating a lie that they've been on the moon by giving us a truth so that we won't question the lie. And yes, the reason why there wasn't a whistleblower from NASA employees is because you can imagine they're all sitting behind their desks and they're being fed the same thing on their screen that we are. So they see the rocket take off and then immediately they're fed this screen and it's just a movie. Let me know below what you think. Did America really land on the moon? And if you really do believe that man has landed on the moon, please explain in a comment to me why we have lost our progress. If we landed on the moon over 50 years ago, we should be so far ahead by now. We should have already been on Mars. But instead, we've gone backwards. In the space, in the way to conquer space, we've gone backwards. So please tell me, wouldn't you think if we were going to conquer space and we were going to go to other planets? Because let's face it, Earth is overpopulated. So it makes sense to conquer other planets and it is possible that we can give Mars an atmosphere. That's been proven. And if we were able to get to the moon 50 years ago, we should by now have been able to have gone to Mars. So if you really believe we landed on the moon, give me a comment. Why did the American American government not only destroy the spaceships, but destroy the blueprints. You wouldn't. You would use those blueprints to build bigger and better and more efficient. So no, America did not land on the moon. But they had to save face because Russia nearly got there. Just saying, you look up these facts for yourself. And I'm only, as I said, this is not a new conspiracy. This conspiracy has been around for ages. I'm just giving it fresh blood. Thanks, guys. Drop a comment below if you believe and you prove it to me. And also, why were there different angles of shadows on the moon? When the light hit, there were different angles. 90 degree angle, anywhere on Earth, sometimes you can have a different slight degree, but not 90 degrees. That's too extreme. All right, cherish every moment, and every life matters. Thank you guys for watching, and I'm open. As I said, I'm a conspiracist, and I'm open to you proving to me that we have landed on the moon. Maybe centuries ago when Atlantis existed, we did, because I've seen enough to believe that in the past that we may have, but not in 1967. Love you guys. Bye.